to be cooperative. India is now joining America and China in a population explosion, you know? And so they have to be very well aware of the energy sources that they use, how their carbon footprint. And so
you talk about how everything has changed, and one of the things that have changed is safety and security. That's why you were at Billy Corgan's event last night, because of the tragedy that happened in Highland Park. Are you taking extraordinary precautions? I mean, you always took extraordinary precautions to keep people safe at Lollapalooza, but is it even more enhanced this year?
Well, I wouldn't say it's any more enhanced than it has been or needs to be, but I think at the root of it all is really these laws that allow people to just grab an AR-15 and start firing from a vantage point. So that's where, to me, taking precautions. Listen, man, we're not talking about muskets anymore. A musket takes you, what, like a minute to reload. You can bring a guy down if he's shooting at you if he's using a musket. We're not using muskets anymore. So we have to be understanding of that. And we have to reach into our hearts and say, look, for the safety of everyone, for the safety of our children, we have to kind of detail how we go about protecting and making sure that we can have a great time and thrive.
Since the last time that we talked, you know, during the pandemic on our TV morning show, I started a cooking segment because we couldn't get any guests. We couldn't get anybody in the studio. So I've started this cooking segment. It's taken off like crazy.
Really?
I can't believe it. So now that I'm talking to people again, interviewing people again, I'm asking for recipe ideas. Are you a cook at all? Do you have a recipe that you love that you can do?
That I can do?
Yeah.
You know, my forte is bachelor food. For years before I was married, I was amazing at coming up with a dish 20 minutes or less.
Good.
You know, you can start with my favorite dish. I would say what I like to do is I wake up in the morning, I make a record selection, I put on a record, at least one side will I play, and I'll make a breakfast. It'll always include a beautiful juice, and then I get into the proteins. I'll do an egg, and then within the egg, that's where you can go crazy with omelet. So you can put in your mushroom and your avocado and your tomato, and you know, the spinach, all these things that you get at the farmer's market, and then maybe even a goat cheese with that, and then a sourdough bread, only one slice. And I'll use either olive oil or butter, a little butter. But then, you know, that meal, that one meal, as they say, breakfast is the most important meal of the day.
Fuels you. I'm going to recreate the Perry Farrell omelet, I'll let you know how all that turns out.
And tell me how you feel through the day.
Oh,
part of it is like,
sounds amazing.
It has to digest.
Yeah.
So you're going about, is that food? And another one, when I'm at Lala, whenever I'm on tour, I always have a juice set up. So fresh juice, you know, celery, tomatoes, I use ginger in there. What else did I have in there? Celery, carrots, spinach, and garlic.
Yeah.
So I crush all that down, and that's what I'm usually drinking when I'm walking around, and it's giving me vitality. And I put a little bit of vodka in there.
Attaboy.
It moves along the blood.
Yeah.
It makes it push through the bloodstream.
There's the rock and roller I wanted to hear.
Put
some vodka in there. Perry, it's great to see you, man.
Great.
Thank you so much. Always appreciate it.